Welcome back to this new video on Microsoft Copilot. Copilot was launched for general public on 15th of January 2024. It's available for all the people in the world and they need to have some prerequisites which are given in the description. You can have a look on that. So now this is a video where I'll be showing you some features, some capabilities of Microsoft Copilot in the Microsoft Word document. Let's try to understand. There are a few examples which I'll be covering in this video. Now, AI is included inside the Office 365 applications and the name is given as Copilot. Let's try to understand. So I've purchased the Copilot license. I have done the installation and all this work. And on the right hand side, you can see in the Home tab, I have this Copilot option available. So when you open a new Word document, you can see a small option, a small Copilot icon would be visible. What things it can do? It can write some text, whatever text you want, it can write the text. You can ask questions to the existing document. So let's try to understand with the first example. Imagine I am a professor or a teacher in some college and school, and I want to create some outline, a course outline for students who want to learn, let's say, Microsoft Excel. So I want to create a course outline for them. Normally, I will go to Google, I will go to ChatGPT and write a data set and I'll try to bring it here. But here within Microsoft Copilot, which is in the Microsoft Word, you can generate the course outline within 60 seconds. I repeat, 60 seconds. Let's try to see. So I can click on this small dot icon and here is the dialog box which comes for Copilot. So it's a draft with Copilot. I can write what I want in this particular box and I can just click on generate option. The generate option is deactivated because no text is there. The number of characters in the prompt can be 2000 characters. So now I can type some prompt, but it will waste your and my time. So what I'm going to do is I will use my voice. The voice, which is speech, will be converted to text in this box and that will become a prompt for the Copilot and it will generate the data. Let's try to do that. So I can click on this box over here and I want to create a course outline for Microsoft Excel for 8 hours. So I can click on this mic option. Create a course outline for Microsoft Excel for duration of 8 hours. Now, this has made some mistake. Create a code something for Microsoft Excel for duration of 8 hours. Now, it is not because of Copilot. It's because of my accent, which I'm not able to, match with the standards. So therefore, it has given some text. So not a problem. I can just edit the same prompt. I can put a backspace and I can say create a course outline. So I can write here course outline. Course outline something for Microsoft Excel, which is duration for 8 hours. So I can just clean this data properly and that. Now I can just click on generate. So remember, usually people used to take 1 hour, 2 hour, 3 hours for doing the same work. Now it can be done in less than 60 seconds. If you put a timer, 60 seconds and you'll get the entire course outline ready. So you can see that's a data which says course overview, which says the modules. Okay, it's still generating. You see that's a working on it. And it's generating the text and the course outline will be ready. So this is for the professor or a teacher in some school and college and some university, they can create an outline. Now, after creating, if I think I made a mistake, I didn't want it for Microsoft Excel. Okay, I wanted the course outline, let's say for Microsoft PowerPoint. I can still edit the same document. Okay, so you can see what I can do is, this is an editable option. I can click on this option. And instead of Excel, I will backspace and put a PowerPoint here. So instead of Excel, I've written as PowerPoint and I can click on generate. So whatever prompt you have written in the Copilot, you can again edit it back. Okay. And still you can get the answers here. So now if you see the title has changed and it has changed to Microsoft PowerPoint and the data or the course outline is ready. Okay. This is for the professors. Now I can click on file and I can click on new document. Now, again, I'm a professor in a college or I'm a trainer in some company and I want to create a test for my students. These are multiple choice questions. I want to create a test which is multiple choice questions on Python and I do not know Python. Okay, will this create it or not? Let's try to understand. I can click here and instead of typing, instead of wasting your and my time, I will use my voice to convert into text. Create 5 multiple choice questions on Python. And I'll just click on generate. So what it will do is, let me just increase the size. Again, as I said, 60 seconds is the time which we can give to the Copilot. Now, when I say 60 seconds, it depends upon your internet connection, your connectivity and all those, considering those. I have a good connection, so 60 seconds. Otherwise, 120, 240, 480, depends. So, 60 seconds, it will create the answers. Now, sometimes it happens, it does not understand properly. So, you have to change the prompt, rewrite it again. So, something it has understood, you see at the back end, create 5 multiple choice questions in Python. Okay, so I can write as Python language and click on generate. So, if it is not understanding, you have to change and write in a detailed manner so that it will give you the answers. So, you see what is the output of the following code? It has given the code in the Python and the answers there. So, this is just 5 questions. I can ask them to write 20, 100, 200 questions. It will give the answers. Maybe if I change this. Yeah. So, I can change this. Instead of Python, I have written as MS Word and I can click on generate. So, 60 seconds, it will give the answer. So, writing the right prompt is also an important thing. And let's see if it generates or not. Let's wait for 60 seconds. And it has created. Okay. So, it's not 100% right. I trust Copilot 70, 80, 90%, not 100%. A person has to be more talented than Copilot in understanding that where it is making some mistakes. So, you need to figure it out. So, people are doing repetitive work in the company. They have to become little smarter because of Copilot has come. So, it is doing all the work instead of a person spending time. You see, all the 5 questions are given here. Okay, that's one beautiful part of Copilot. So, again, I can go back and create a blank document. Second, another example I can say, I want to compare 2 famous actors in the world and I want to create a table in the Microsoft Word. Normal person will take minimum 60 minutes to get the data from the Google and get the answers. What I want is, I want Copilot to save my 60 minutes. 60 minutes should come down to 60 seconds. Let's try to do it. Here, again, the same prompt dialog box. What I want is, I want to compare 2 famous actors in the world. So I can click here. Compare 2 famous actors in the world, Shah Rukh Khan and Tom Cruise. Give me the output in the table format. So, when the prompt is written, I have to check whether it has made mistakes or not. Compare 2 famous actors in the world, Shah Rukh Khan and Tom Cruise. Give me the output in the table format. So, you see, compared the output. So, I have to say compare, not in the past tense. Click on generate. Now, normally, if I want to actually compare those 2 people, I have to spend a lot of time. Now, why I've said Shah Rukh Khan and Tom Cruise, these are famous people in the world. But think of your work related. You can think of boring subjects which you want to compare. Compare with Microsoft Excel, with Microsoft PowerPoint. Or compare Power BI with ClickView, or compare with A college with B college, it will still give you the answers. Okay. And you see, in 60 seconds, it has given you all the answers. So, Shah Rukh Khan versus Tom Cruise, a comparison of 2 famous actors, and it has given me all the answers here. Now, if I'm a YouTuber and I can create a video and I can compare those 2 pictures or 2 famous actors, put some photos, and the video content is ready. Okay. And you see, it has given me all the answers. So, debut film was The Deewana 1992, Endless Love 1981. And you can see all the comparisons are given between these 2 people. Okay. So, as I said, this is something which everybody knows in the world. But think of a boring subject. If you want to compare book A with book B, if you want to compare designation A with designation B, you can still do that. Now, moving on to the forward, another example. Suppose this is a document created. And if I want to ask questions to this particular document, imagine I have 100 pages of Word document and there is some information which will take some time to search. Okay, I might use Control F, find option. But suppose I want to understand that in a proper manner. How do I do that? Let's see an example. So if you see, height is 1.3 meters of Shah Rukh Khan and height is 1.7 meters of Tom Cruise. Now, if I want to see the height of Tom Cruise, I can click on Copilot. So, Copilot on the right hand side comes, whatever questions I have in this particular document, I can ask them. Now, this is something which I've shown you and then I am preparing a question, right? So, I can click here. What is the height of Tom Cruise? Right. So, you see, this question has been written here and the question here is, what is the height of Tom Cruise? So, any question from the document you can ask and I can click on send. This will analyze the entire document, the Word document, and it will give the answers. So remember, I have become lazy and smart at the same time. I'm not using my keyboard to type it. I'm using my voice to convert into text and Copilot to give me the answers. Imagine previously the time taken was huge. and you can see 1.7 meters. Secondly, I can ask one more question to validate. Awards and nominations. Okay, so I can ask about the Shah Rukh Khan, how many awards he has, you know, got. So I can click here. How many awards Shah Rukh Khan has got till today? So I have pronounced by mistake something wrong. So you have to say as got till date. And then I can click on send. So it will analyze the entire document, give me the answers here. Now, as I said, this is a interesting document. In your company, the documents might be boring. Legal agreements, legal documents, maybe some marketing strategy or some documents. You can ask some serious questions to that document. It will give you the answers. Copilot is a game-changing tool in all the Microsoft applications. This is the first video on Microsoft Copilot in the Word document. And you'll see many, many examples coming soon in the Excel, in the Outlook, in the Teams and so on. So you see, it has given all the answers about how many awards Shah Rukh Khan has got. Okay. Same way, I'll come back to the next document. Now, this is a rental agreement document. Please have a look. Rental agreement document. And it gives me all the information. I am sure that everybody might have stayed at the rental place, especially if you're changing the city. So what I want to understand is the rent should be paid on before 7th of each month. Okay, 7th of each month. And the number of pages this document is having, how many? 4 pages. Okay, so here using Copilot, I can ask them by what date should I pay the rent? Okay, so it says, if I scroll down, somewhere I'll be getting the answer here. The rent shall be paid on or before 7th day of each month. What is the last date on which I can pay the rent? And now I can just click on send. So what is the last day of the month where I can pay the rent? It will give the answers. If it is not giving the answers, I have given some wrong prompt. So what is a prompt? Is the way or the method which you're asking a question to that document. So let's see if it is giving the answer, if my prompt is right. Okay. So yes, the prompt is right. According to the document, the rent must be paid on or before of 7th of each month. Okay. So which is very great. Okay. I can see this example. Now the last one is, suppose it has created some paragraph here. Okay, that's a paragraph which is created. Now, I think this particular paragraph is not up to the mark. I want to change this paragraph and I get some different answers. So at that point of time, I can select this text over here. You see how I'm using without using any keyboard. I'm just selecting this text. I want this particular paragraph to be formatted. How do I do that? Okay, on the right hand side, if you see, there's a small Copilot icon. I can click here and I can say rewrite with Copilot. So what it will do is, it will Google out, it will find using ChatGPT and all and find out the right options. It will give you the options as well. 60 seconds and it has given me 3 different options. I'm not reading the entire document, but you can see that's a document 1, that's a paragraph 2, that's a paragraph 3. Now, it depends upon me which paragraph I want to use. Remember, AI generated content may be incorrect. It's not always correct here. Okay, so I can replace, I can insert below, okay, or I can refresh. So I'll say I want to replace and the text has been replaced over here. So this is what Copilot is and it is doing wonders. Now, there might be people who might be asking that this is also possible with ChatGPT. What is the difference between Copilot and the ChatGPT? Remember, you cannot share your personal documents in ChatGPT. If it is 3.5, 4.0, if you're in a working in a corporate company and environment, your data is confidential. You cannot share that data in the, you know, ChatGPT or Google and ask the questions. The Copilot is a GPT inside your office applications where your confidential data can be shared with this Copilot and you can ask the questions. Okay. And it will give you the answers related to your personal data. So that's a major difference between these two, ChatGPT and the Copilot. Secondly, Copilot is an ecosystem. It is connecting to the entire ecosystem. Word, Excel, PowerPoint and everything, Outlook and Teams as well. So I can ask in Teams questions related to Excel. In Excel, I can ask questions related to Teams and vice versa. So there's a, you know, collaboration between all the tools in Microsoft 365. Now, this is again confidential data, which GPT 4.0 cannot solve. I cannot share the confidential data. If you're a small company, startup company, if you don't worry about the data, it's fine. You can upload and start asking questions. It will give the answers. That's a major difference. So I hope you have understood the Copilot in Microsoft Word. Stay tuned for the other videos on Excel, Outlook and Teams and 365 application with the Microsoft Copilot. That's all for this video.